made this beautiful place here, and it reminds me how beautiful life actually is. With such a beautiful view, how blessed I am that God gave me this life. Wow. It felt like God lifted me up the moment I fell from the scooter, and God whispered to me, "Everything is love. Take back your powers. They are yours." I busted my knees, couldn't walk, and gained a lot of extra weight. But the feeling of a high spirit kept on running through my veins, realizing that life can be over in 2 seconds. I'm back in control. Thank you, God, for giving me life all over again. There was a moment in time where I needed to find myself back. I was so obsessed with achieving that I forgot to take care of my mind and soul. I had a few bookings in the Caribbean, so I decided to take a long vacation with it. But when I started my vacation and didn't need to work anymore, it hit me really hard. I was really tired and exhausted. Losing myself was the worst thing. For real. Mostly because I don't like to share how I really feel. My inner self knew that I was depressed and not happy with myself. Every day, I was acting like I was happy, but I wasn't. I always been in a mode where I had to prove myself in anything that I had to do. I decided to not allow myself to be someone who constantly has to prove myself to others.
It's very important, like, not only as a community, but also as, like, people to look out for each other in those parts of their lives, because I felt like it could have been, it easily could have been a drop due to people's way of thinking and approaching, like, the humanity side of the business side. Like, it's crazy because I can't really explain how this went down, but you have, like, in this game you have business and you have humanity, and those two don't go along. They don't go along that well.
D has been shifting himself a lot. He has been going through some situations what made him realize a lot about himself, a lot about his vision about life, and go on about this. So I think it's really nice that he combines this with his passion, with dance, the love of the art. Because he's not the type of person that talks, you know. So he is talking by his art, he's talking by his concept, visuals and stuff. And for me, if you take a concept of him from a few years ago, comparing with now, it's a huge difference. Of course, you can see it's steps by him, but the concept and the thought of it, it's completely different, because also as a person, he has changed.
So, I'm back in Holland, guys, and I can't sleep. In less than 4 hours, I already need to go to rehearsal. Rehearsal for some concept videos that I'm shooting. I'm so excited to show you guys. Alright, I'm gonna try to sleep again. When I arrived in Holland, I started immediately with working. I asked some talented people to join me on this project that I had inside my head for so long. The hunger and the will was bigger than ever. I didn't create something for at least 2 months, so I was so excited to start this journey, you know?
Sometimes you work with somebody and there was really a connection. You know, you don't have to explain a lot. I know what he wants. He know what I wanted. So it feel good. It felt good. It was a really connection. And his mindset of making videos, or his concept of choreographing stuff, is amazing, and he's doing his job.
I remember creating this whole concept video in like 4 days with these people. It felt so good, and like the vibe was also really good. So I stayed for another week in Holland, but I made the decision already to go back to Aruba, because there was still something deep inside me that knew that it wasn't the right time to be in this environment again. So I booked myself a ticket back to the islands. Later on, I think I knew that I made a mistake of going back to Aruba, because I put my family in a situation that they didn't know what I was going through. The only thing they saw was me being in my room or me going to the beach.
If I knew it all, then would I do it again? Would I do it again? If they knew what they said would go straight to my head, what would they say instead? If I knew it all, then would I do it again? Would I do it again? If they knew what they said would go straight to my head, what would they say instead?
When Daequan went to Aruba, his intentions were to clear his mind and to escape the environment he was in. He was calling me every day to talk about his frustrations, because he and his father was not on the same page. I think Daequan's father didn't know what what Daquan's purpose was, being in Aruba, but at the end it was a good opportunity for them to bond with each other.
Me wanting so many things at the same time did actually stress me out. I started teaching some classes in Aruba again after a while of doing nothing. And later on, Bonaire also gave me some workshops over there. And I really enjoyed it a lot. It gave me my love for my passion back. The way these kids are dreaming, the way these kids actually work is insane. The humbleness of these kids made me realize why I started dancing in the first place. I remembered why teaching was so important for me. Seeing those kids wanna have what I have made me realize that I have to appreciate everything more. After my accident, I thought, okay, this is enough. Enough of feeling sorry for myself. I already felt 10 times better, but this accident actually woke me up. And the funny thing was, I had some gigs in Holland waiting on me, and I couldn't even walk normal. But I knew I was ready again. So I rested my body for 2 weeks and I made myself ready to work myself again, but on a such more healthier way. After my long journey, I was happy to be back. Blessed with new opportunities and new challenges. I promised myself to enjoy everything way more than I did before. Everyone welcomed me with open arms. And once again, I was just happy to be back at home, you know? Closing this personal chapter did me really good, and I can advise everyone to go back to the source. Go back to yourself and figure out what you really want in life. I wish that I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. This is my moment, I just feel so alive. Sometimes life asks way too much from us. Taking a break of something you really love is okay, you know? It's okay to seek yourself in the mirror and be like, what the fuck did I been through? Just inhale and exhale, and it's all gonna be alright.
got the drip.
Having the right people around me is really important for me and my creativity. That's something that I value a lot. I hate to be in a toxic place where people constantly shade other people or simply just don't uplift others, you know? I used to be really trustful and give people opportunities, but I changed that immediately after some situations kept repeating themselves. I am really selective who I let in my camp or who I trust, or more important, who I choose to work with, because people don't always mean well. Sometimes people have other intentions, and I want to protect myself for that.
He is so humble and always so willing to, you know, listen to people. And he has this thing about his character that always triggers me. It's like, he's not cocky, but you can kick your ass. So that's a difference. Like, most dancers have it the other way around. They can kick your ass, but they're cocky. I'm like, yo, I kick your ass in class. But to see him grow as a choreographer, that's really dope. And to see that up close, because I have, like, being in the scene, you have a lot of friends that do this, but it's different when he does it.
Everything is love, and I force myself to go through life like that.
Understand that we are put on earth to love. That's all it's about. Everybody want to figure out how complicated life is and break it down. This is what I truly think. I really think that it's going to keep going on. War going to keep going on. Frustration going to keep going on. Anger going to keep going on till we finally go back down to the simplest word, love.
So when Daquan came back from Aruba, you really saw that he had a kind of different vibe. He had more positive energy. He was more peaceful. And you also saw that back in the videos that he delivered. People were more connected. The dancers that he asked were also friends. So everyone felt really comfortable with each other.
The work that he delivered before, it was great. It was amazing. The work that he delivered after he came back for the second time, it was pure, it was very deep. You could feel the pain that he lived through. You could feel like the growth that he went through. He put it all into his work, and it was all beautiful pieces that would connect all kind of people from all over Holland. Together, it would bring people together, would make people cry, would make people laugh. So I think that journey was very rough for him, but I think it was much needed because he came out of it a bit a better person.
Ontzettend dankbaar voor jullie positieve energie en jullie inzet de afgelopen weken, en dat jullie zo hard hebben gewerkt, oprecht. En dat jullie gestroken hebben, dat jullie heel veel uren hebben gezeten. De mensen die niet de eerste paar dansjes waren. En nogmaals, ik dank jullie voor jullie support voor de afgelopen jaren. De mensen die jullie net bij zijn gekomen. One family, thank you so much. En applaus voor jullie.
Creating with a meaning in my projects, it's so important for me to express myself as an artist. These couple of years, I've been educating myself a lot in history. I am a Black African European, of which my roots lay in North Africa and South America. When this Pacific Elevate show came around, I had the intention to create a special piece, as well because I knew this was my last piece with Global Dance Center, but as well to pave the respect for the people who paved the way for us. Not knowing what I really wanted to create, but after seeing When They See Us, that shows injustice towards people with color, I felt a certain way and my view on life changed completely, and so did my inspiration. It made me very emotional for the people who suffered. I was angry for a lot of days, so I decided to create this Freedom, Justice and Equality piece. And this show, it shows how far we as a community are, and witness the power of unity. Together we can achieve greatness, and that makes this piece even more special and intense.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours.
Hi, I'm Danielle Pakes, and I'm working for Team Eva Simmons. I ended up at the Instagram of The Quant, and there was one video in particular where I think he was in London, and I was intrigued because The Quant, he's not a small guy, we all know that. And that's why I had so much more love for him, because he was totally himself. He had so much energy and I wanted more of that energy, so I thought, shit, who is this guy? And I'm gonna send him a text and let's see what he's doing. He's in London, but maybe he wants to come back to Amsterdam and work with us.
Being on stage and creating for an artist, that is something I always wanted to do when I was younger. I feel when you just do whatever you need to do, with good intentions of course, every blessing will come on your path. Choreographing and dancing for Eva Simmons was such an honor, especially because it was my first solo job as a choreographer. Normally, I always had assisting jobs, so everything was always already thought out. But this time, I was totally free to book my own dancers and to work out the visions that I had in mind. Eva herself is also really creative in everything that she does, so this was a great match. It was really nice to learn as well from her and her team. I am so used to not dancing my own pieces anymore, because I told myself after my first injury that I only wanted to choreograph. And I remember Dan saying to me, I want you to choreograph and dance for this tour, just so you know. And I was like, oh no, And she was like, oh yeah. I really loved how she pushed me to do both.
We are doing sound check right now. I think everybody's a bit excited. I'm working with a young crew right now, and a lot of them never have performed on a stage like this.
The Quant is still very young, but he knows, he has a vision, he knows what he wants. And I think in the music world, it's really hard to work with artists who always have their own vision, and they will give you the freedom to do your own thing. But he will listen to the artist, he will try to understand what his or her vision is. And I have respect for that. I have respect for that you push yourself to the fullest. You never give up, and you expect from your students or your team the same, like give everything or go home. And I'm really, really curious to see what's going on after the corona, what the world will bring for us all, and how we will live together, and what the Quant will accomplish with his crazy mind and good energy. I think for people in the music industry, there are so many crazy people out there with wrong intentions or whatever, but the most important thing is be honest, work hard, and depend on yourself, depend on your own knowledge and the power that you have. And if you can bring that over to other people, then you are a very special guy. So the Quant, thank you for working with you, and hope to see you soon. Bye.
The reason why I wanted to create this personal commentary is not for people to feel sorry for me, but to encourage people. Everyone goes through certain phases in their life, but I feel these phases are here to create us to who we are. And I am extremely thankful for every moment in my life, because they created me the way I am today. I learned a lot from these life lessons, as I call them.
Everybody's free to feel good. Everybody's free to feel good. Everybody's free.
Excited what the future will bring for me. I promised myself to work harder on my goals. I don't want to put that much pressure on everything, but my vision of what I want is clear. This whole corona situation is annoying, as I was supposed to start a new chapter in London. But then once again, that's just how life is. Make the best of it. This was my documentary, Mirrors, a reflection of myself. Everything is Love by the Quant.